So today I start off with a prayer. Dear Lord, please help me because I cannot do this on my own. I pray that everyone will have open hearts, open minds as I challenge them, and that I can speak through you, God, and that these words will not be my own. Give me courage to speak, and that these people will have the courage to listen to what I say. I pray that these people's lives will be impacted by the words that I have to say to them, just as my life has been impacted by the experience that I did this year. And I ask that you bless everyone here, and that everyone has a good day. Amen. All right, so for our first part of our experience, we had challenged ourselves with a virtue, and so I decided to choose something that I'm particularly weak in. I'm not particularly good at giving or charity, so I decided that I wanted to help veterans. I didn't really know why, but as I thought about it, I really enjoy being around veterans. They're tough, they have grit. They're just some of the most real people that I've ever met. And part of why I also decided to help veterans is that they know how the world works. They've been through hard, they've been through the darkest and deepest places of the earth, and they've also seen the brightest places, such as America. So I decided to help the people that I really respect the most. So I came in wanting giving as a virtue. So I decided to go volunteer at a VA hospital. But I came in with the wrong intent. I came in being selfish. I came in wanting to have a conversation with veterans because they're real. You know what they think. You know basically everything they're about within 15 minutes of talking to them, and that's something that I really, really appreciated. But as I walked in, I realized that this was not the experience that I was looking for. I walked in and there was a veteran on a gurney and then another man who had both of his legs blown off in full uniform. And it was at that moment that I realized that this is the other side of what veterans have to go through. So what I ended up doing is I was a transport at the VA hospital. I would transport veterans from their rooms to appointments, dialysis, physical therapy, whatever. But I started reading their waiver form. I had to sign a release form. And as I started reading, I learned that I could not talk to them. I just had to tell them where they're going, get them there safely, and that I couldn't touch them. So a 90-year-old man struggling to get out of his car, couldn't touch him. If he fell, I was liable. So I had to practice restraint. And that was really hard. So to start off with my second point, for my second experience, we were told to choose a professional experience, and I was clueless on every level. I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't even have a particular field. I have interests, I have hobbies, but nothing that I could really shadow and pursue in the future. So I was very frustrated. I just wanted to get it done. But God had a plan, and I was really blind to it. So I received a call from a parent of a friend, Nathan Sloan, Nathan Sloan's dad. What he does is a geographical mapping. And as I received this call, I was blessed, and I was happy that God gave me an opportunity to go and shadow. I did not think that I would not have to look, but the opportunity would have to come to me. So that was very blessed. So I ended up touring a government facility, ended up seeing GIS, Geographical Information Systems. So it's basically the new way that they do mapping, the government. So what they'll do is they take drones and they'll attach cameras to them and fly them over large areas, state parks. They can count invasive species, what type of plants are there, what they need to remove. And also, it's just a new and thriving business. I was very happy that I ran into that because it's new. There's young people being involved. It's not as a lot of school, but it is a much needed job. And, so I was blessed with that. So as you know, for one of my virtues, I chose giving. So I start off with Philippians 2:3. Do nothing out of selfish, vain, or conceit, but treat others how you would want to be treated. So through this experience, I learned that charity can be greedy. I went to the Veterans Hospital wanting something for myself rather than wanting to help. So the doing charity for personal gain isn't charity. And I'm typically a greedy person. I give money way too much power. Money really affects a lot that I do, where I go to eat, what type of clothes that I wear, what car that I drive. I genuinely thought that if I had enough money, that I could get through the year happy, that I get through the year just content, I can eat wherever I want, I don't have to, you know, eat bad lunches every day. But I thought that it'd make me happy. And so today I bring a quote by Charles Sturgeon. No one is as miserable as a poor person who has the appearance of wealth. And that really brought out to me is that there are two different types of being poor. There's being poor in wealth, and there's being poor in relationships and family. And those are the two things that really make you happy. So there can be poor people, but as long as they have a support system, friends, family, they can be one of the happiest people on earth. As if someone's rich at the top of the hill and they're alone, they're not happy at all. So basically through this, I learned that God, relationships, and family, to focus on God, relationships, instead of money. One thing that I learned throughout this year the most is that I don't know the plan. God does. Throughout this year, every adult that I really talk to, almost every person asks me, hey, what are you going to do for your future? What college are you going to go to? And this question made me angry. It made me furious because everybody else says, you know, I want to go into business. I want to go into sports psychology. But I have no clue. And so just being berated with this question really, really made me angry. So I was very uncomfortable, felt kind of lost. And then I came across this quote from one of my favorite artists, Chris Stapleton. And basic quote is, I don't know where I'm going, but I've got to go because every turn reveals another road. And this really, really comforted me. That once I move on to the next chapter of my life, once I graduate high school, that I'm not lost, but I have another road that I'm just going to go on to. It's different from a lot of other people. And another verse that I chose was Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. So I was kind of angry at God at one point because I didn't know. And so I felt helpless. But this reminded me that God has a plan for your future. Not to hurt you, but to give you a prosperous future. And so for an overview, I went to the Veterans Hospital. I went in wanting something, and then ended up getting something completely different. I really wanted like a specific goal, a passion, a professional field that I wanted to go into, but that did not happen. And I found out that God has ultimate plan, and that my life is not my own, and that everything will work itself out eventually. At the conclusion of this year, I'm going to go to ACC, take some general education classes, and then end up going to New Zealand and YWAM, and do YWAM in pursuit of what I really want to do for the future. And hopefully after this year, I'll know what I want to do. So my main challenge is for those like me. If you don't know what you're doing, it's okay. I cannot stress that enough. College is not the only route. My grandparents, my uncle, didn't go to college. And they're successful, have families, they're very well off. So college is not the only route. And not that you shouldn't be looking for a route, because you should. You should strive for a profession. But if you don't know, you don't know. If there's no plan, don't feel helpless. Just think of it as you're a wanderer or a traveler. That as you get off this road, there's another road that you go on. There's a plan, and I bring back Jeremiah 29:11. I have plans to prosper you and not harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. So today, I end with a prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for today, and thank you for the opportunity to go to this school. I pray that the people I talk to will be encouraged to have faith in bad situations, have faith in not only uncertainty in their lives, but have faith in God to help them through it, and be reminded that God has a plan, and he will help not only me, but others through their lives, and be reminded that God has a plan for all of us. God has the ultimate plan. Through this crazy year, I've learned how blessed I am, not only where I live, what family I was born into, what school I go to, but realizing that my life is not my own. I'd hoped to be going to college, had a specific goal, but that was not the plan for me. So I pray that throughout today and through the rest of our lives, that we would be reminded that God has a plan. And I also pray that the people I challenge today will do charity for the unselfish act of giving, and for the genuine want to make people's lives better. And if we do these acts without the right motive in mind, then it is no charity at all. And we'll take the challenge of having faith, not knowing the plan, and not worrying the situation is going to turn out well. But they'll trust God, just because as you, just as you, God, were brought into this world, we're meant to serve and not be served.